I recently built the world's largest aquarium sump, and before I show it to you and introduce you to it, let me explain what an aquarium sump is in the first place.
I guess we could start over here because there's a sump over here.
A sump is a volume of water, goes below your aquarium, acts as your filtration.
Water comes into the sump, it's mechanically filtered, goes through biological media where it's biologically filtered,
and of course you can have chemical media or whatever you want, and then returned to the main aquarium with your pump.
Benefits of a sump are, of course, you get water skimming, because typically speaking, you also have a weir. A weir is kind of like a baffle, like over here on the electric eel tank, where water's kind of skimmed over from the surface of the aquarium, taking out any sort of protein skim, and going through the plumbing down into your sump.
You also get that extra water volume. Obviously, that sump is additional water added to the system, so you get additional dilution, plus aquarium sumps typically hold way more biological media than your typical filtration system.
The benefits are great, but they can be noisy, they can be way more expensive, and they require you a lot of the times to drill your aquarium. And a lot of people simply don't want to do that, so they'll go with hang on the backs, canisters, whatever you want to do. I taught about all of this in the Ultimate Do-It-Yourself Handbook for the Do-It-Yourself Aquarist. 552 pages. But the chapter on filtration is by far my favorite chapter, because we go over things that are not on the internet, that nobody talks about, that is timeless information, and is my favorite chapter. If you have this book, let me know what you think about the chapter on filtration. I already know. With that said, how do you know how big of a tank you should use a sump? A lot of them are 15-gallon tanks. But let me put it into perspective for you. Imagine, for example, you had a 180-gallon aquarium. 2 feet tall, 2 feet wide, 6 feet long. To figure out the size of the sump that you need to have and why the world's largest sump that I just built is so huge, we need to calculate how much water is at the top inch of your aquarium. And like I said, it's 24 inches wide and it's 72 inches long. So we'd multiply the width by the length, so 24 by 72 divided by 1, so you don't even have to divide it because 1 kind of cancels it out. And then you want to divide that number by 231, because there's 231 cubic inches to a gallon. And what we get is 7.48 gallons, 7.5 gallons, which means if we times that by the total height, which is 24, there's our 180 gallons. So why the top inch? When the power goes out, I like to assume as a safety factor that an inch of water is gonna drain out of the tank. So so your sump would have to be at least 7.5 gallons, but that means it's running empty the whole time. 7.5 times 2 means 15. I could put a 15-gallon sump under there, but that means when it's running, meaning that the water's sucking out of here, pumping up to this main aquarium, it'll run at around 50%. Power shuts off, it's gonna fill up all the way to the top because the water has to overflow and drain to it. Would I put a 15-gallon aquarium on a 180-gallon tank? Bare minimum. I would probably go with 30-gallon, possibly 40. But that's the basic calculation. So what if I told you this? What if I built a sump for my 180-gallon aquarium, but the sump was 25,000 gallons? Would that be ridiculous? I think so. That would be 144 times the main size of the tank. Great for water dilution, but total waste. I should probably start with the beginning with how I came to build this sump that's 144 times the main aquarium. Once again, starts with the piranha tank. Dealing with some algae issues right now, and I'm about to fix them. In order for me to fix this issue and the plans that I have, I got to take everything out of here. All the piranha got to come out, and I've got to take all the plants out, unfortunately. In order for me to place them somewhere, because these guys are big. I got a bunch of small tanks, but not a bunch of big empty tanks. I had to drain my saltwater tank and hook it up as a freshwater. Which basically means take all the water out, clean it up, dry it out, put the water circulation back on. And before I transfer these guys, I'll take one of their canister filters and put it on that 180 for the time being. And my saltwater fish will go down here into a 60 gallon. There's where my lionfish is with all of his, well, they look like plants, but that's macroalgae. He's only in there temporarily because I needed his tank. Now, obviously you guys remember, this is a freshwater setup where all of these tanks drain into the sump. They used to, one tank would go into here, next tank would overflow, go into this one, but I just simply bypassed it and made it go straight, turn that overflow upside down.
on this aquarium so no water can get out, and then simply put his filter on this tank. He'll do just fine.
And he is, he's awesome. But wasn't there an Oscar in this tank? Yes, I needed his tank because remember when I said, when I got all frustrated, like, oh, I need this tank, I need to do this, I have so many plans. The plan was to move that Oscar
to the quarantine tank where all of the new Icara are, but they got ick and I had to treat it. They were completely recovered, but they went ahead and bred again. So that's been a blast. But the first time they bred, and the reason I couldn't move them is because they had fry in the tank and I put all the fry inside to this little tank, which you can't really see, but the lot's in there and they're all swimming around. So with that tank being occupied, where am I supposed to put the Oscar?
Well, I went outside digging around in some tanks and found a 18 gallon cube I also built. Tossed a little fake plant in here. And the Oscar's in here now. Look at him, he's getting bigger. He's about 4 inches now. He's doubled in size, but his coloration is what is like literally to die for. He'll go with the rest of the Oscars here shortly, giving us a total of, is it 8 or 9? Let me count. 1, 2, 3. These guys are the twins. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 Oscars.
But I don't want to have to hook up a filter. He's already gone through his quarantine phase. Why not just put a small pump in the 2000, drill the tank, and have it overflow into the 2000. Meaning the 2000 gallon is now his filter. The pump is way back there behind the background, and then the return is in front of it. Now you'll also notice a big pump there that's pumping thousands of gallon out an hour to kind of blow his flow out of there. But the water goes from his tank into the 2000, which overflows in the back, goes into a 180 gallon sump, which also has a 375 gallon aquarium attached, making his sump 144 times bigger than he needs. Oh, that was calculated with just the 2000. So 2000 plus 180 plus 375 plus like 18 gallons, 2,573 gallons of water volume in that little cube. That's 16 by 16 by 16 inches. Pretty cool, but brings up a really interesting idea because I used to do this all the time, and it's also going to explain why the 15s are there. I get these crazy ideas, and a lot of people are saying in the comment section below, Joey has ADHD, and a lot of things is with people with ADHD, they need constant stimulation, constant change, and that's their form of meditation. My hobby is my form of meditation, and unfortunately, I do have ADHD. It's embarrassing to admit it, but I just don't like when people make fun of it because it's not my fault. It's not something I can control. I've tried to medicate myself and it doesn't end well for me. So just let me do my thing out here, guys. I'm not alone. Lots of people have this. With that said, I thought, wouldn't it be cool to just take 15 gallon tanks and I could go 1, 2, 3, because this is 7 feet and these are 2 feet. So 2, 4, 6, it would leave a foot here, but 15s are 12 inches wide. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I'd have a big opening here that's 6 feet wide, and then do the same over there. I thought, I don't know, maybe one day, let me know your thoughts on that idea of lining this. And it's fine to overhang with these glass tanks. I just need the front and backs to kind of be supported. Other than that, trust me, it's fine. I guess I could put a board here and there. It's not like a 1.5 inch board, it'll be fine. But let me know if you think of that, what you think of that idea, or is it too cluttered? And then I drill into the backs and have them all connected, and maybe have one return pump go for all four of these, one control pump for all four of those. Never have to do water changes because once I connect all of these tanks together, they're going on an automated drip system. I might even do RODI water exclusively, but once I get this side of the gallery done, guys, I'm gonna do this side of the entire gallery, but I have to get it all done, everything done before the new year because of my other big plans that have absolutely nothing to do with the aquarium gallery that I've been planning for many, many months, probably 2 years now. And it's happening 100% in the spring. I'm excited, but I can't tell you what it is. Also, my hair still hasn't grown back. At least I still have hair. Anyways, that's how I built the world's biggest sump. I hope you guys get the idea of how to size your sumps, how to build your sumps. I've got a tremendous amount of videos. I think I have like 100 videos on how to build aquarium filters, but every once in a while, if you're not quarantining the fish, consider putting your aquariums a little bit higher. And these ones are really high because they're sitting on top of a concrete tank. But maybe if you have a tank just a little bit taller than the other one,
There's no reason why that tank can't feed both tanks. You're just increasing the water volume. You already have enough filtration, water circulation. It'll be fine. I used to do it all the time. That's how I used to stack my tanks. If you already do this and you didn't even really realize it, let me know in the comment section below, because I think it's more common than people say. Anyways, hope you enjoyed today's video. Brought you up to speed that things are moving along. I'll see you in the next one, which is, you're gonna have a really big eye-opener to what the plans actually are. I hope to be able to film this tonight, but I've gotta be in another province tomorrow to film as well. So we'll see what happens.